Today we'll come up with a new lesson, lesson number 7, advanced features of Excel. Before we are moving to the Excel chapter, till now we learned that how to enter the data, how to edit the data, okay, how to restrict the cell entries, so many things we have learned till now. Now, in this chapter, we are going to learn that how to insert the chart. First, before we are going to move to the chart, how to insert, we want to know the meaning of the chart. Chart is an effective way to display the data in a pictorial form. And this chart is easier to draw. When you are charting in Excel, it is very easy to draw. And we can, why we are inserting the charts, why we are using the charts to compare and what the analyze the growth, relationship and trends among the values in a range. So when we insert the chart, the data is displayed in a special window called what? A data sheet. So I will show you one example. For example, if I inserted a chart, this chart, select the data. How to insert the chart, that part I want you to know. Select the data, okay, go to insert. Here they are having the different types of charts. Just you select any column chart, okay, it will be displayed in a different window. This is called what? A data sheet window. It will open in a own spacing, that is called what? A data sheet. Okay, next one, data sheet I told. Now components of charts. The chart area, the various components of chart, here we are having already it is there in one example. The chart area, it includes the area and object in a chart. Here row one it is mentioned here, right? Here the area, what it is, includes the object in a chart. When you are already, people are learned in the mathematics, category axis, right? The category axis or x-axis is the horizontal axis of a chart, right? Second one you see here, category axis. Here what? Arshia, Vinod, Monica, Aman, Ardika, Ashish. These are what? Category names. In which axis they are? In the x-axis. That is what? A horizontal axis. Next one is what? Value axis. Value axis. For example, the Arshia, we know this is the score of the particular students. The value axis, it is what? In a mathematics we have learned. Okay, it is a y-axis. It's a vertical. And why we are using? To plot the values. Data series. These are fourth one. These are data series. These are the bars or slices. Other elements, the data values here represent. So Arshia, how much she scored? 90. The Vinod, the score in with the help of slices, we can easily come to know the how much they scored. Next one is what? Category names are the label which are displayed on the x-axis and y-axis. See here, Arshia, Vinod, these are what? The names and the numbers. It will be displayed on the x-axis as well as y-axis. Plot area, it is a window within a chart which contain the actual chart. It includes the plotted data, the data series, category and value axis as well. The finally, the seventh component of a chart is what? A legend. It depicts the colors, patterns or symbols assigned to a data series. So here in the data series, what color we are assigned to a particular data series with the help of pattern and colors. Okay, next, creating a chart, I told you already. So how we have to create a chart? So here, open any Excel sheet. Select a particular data. Already I entered the data, select it. Okay, select, go to insert, where you have to click on the insert tab. We are having column chart, line chart, pie chart, bar chart, area chart, scatter, other charts also available in a Excel, which you want to see in your Excel sheet that you have to insert. I want to insert what? A column chart. Okay, I want to insert what? Column chart. So select it. It will be open in a different window. This is called what? Already earlier only I told you, it is a data sheet window. Okay, for example, if I want to make a changes in this chart, so here in the layout tab, we can change a chart title. Select here chart, where you want chart title, select here center. I want, okay, here chart title, what it is, marks of the student. Mark here, you know, click here, double click on marks. Okay, and here like this, for example, chart axis title, chart axis title, what I want to, primary or horizontally, how we want, just title below or above the axis. Here what, here name of the student. Earlier what you are having, that you have to delete it, and name of the student, name of the student. Okay, right. Same thing, if you want to make a changes in the legend also, if you want to legends, where you want to see the legends, this is English total, where you want to, they are depicted with the colors, patterns, I told now only, where you want to show up, here we got, okay, where the position you want to see in a chart, you can place by using, and data labels, where you want the data label, center, CF, center game, okay, like this, we can edit the chart inside, wherever you want, okay, data table, like this, for example, show the data table, we can get, no, just none the door, we can do according to as per our requirement. Next one, some commonly used charts are there, I'm going to read out that what charts we are using. Different types of charts are available in Excel, already that part I told you. Some of the most commonly used charts are what? Column chart. Why we are using this column chart? It's used to display the data in the form of vertical bars, and it shows the data change over a period of time or a comparison among the different data items. And the bar chart, this chart displays the data in the form of long rectangular rods, also called water bars, that are placed vertically or horizontally. Even they are in a bar chart, the bars are placed vertically or horizontally on chart area, and the chart area illustrates the comparison among the individual items. Already I shown you one student's record. Okay, a line chart is a form of a line. It's very similar to plotting the graph on a graph paper with its values and x-axis and y-axis. A line chart uses the connecting the dots to display the trends in a data over a period of time. Pie chart. The chart displays the data in the form of circle that makes up a data series to the sum of items. It always shows only one data series, useful when you want to emphasize on a significant element. So this is regarding what a chart. Now we'll come to the formatting a chart. What type of formatting we can do? Formatting means what? Already in a third lesson only I told, it improves the appearance of a chart. Okay, and what type of format we can add in the title, right? That part I showed you. Changing the text, font line, color, width, border style, legends, data series, etc. If you want to make any changes in the font line, color, width, border style, we can make. And we can also change the number on the values of a x-axis, axis, hide or show the grid lines, etc. Okay, now I will show you how to change the background and color pattern. Okay, just what you have to go to the Excel sheet. Go to Excel sheet. See here, this is my chart now. Okay, what you have to do, right click, select the chart, select the chart. Select the chart, right click, and in that what you have to select, format, plot, whichever you want, format chart area, format plot area, whichever you want to select here. For example, now formatted chart area I am select here. Okay, now in a solid chart, what color I want to be, close it. Okay, this is a plot area. Okay, I want to change the form, select it. Okay, plot area, plotting the values, select it. Now what you want to format the data series, whatever the make you have to check, just right click which options. For example, here fill you select solid fill and select the color which you want. Okay, it's here the data. Like this we can format. Same thing, if you want to format these legends, select format legend. Okay, what you want to, border color if you want to change for that, gradient line, okay, we can change. See here, this gradient line I took white, it will be displayed as a white. And just whatever you want to make a changes, just take your mouse pointer and right click, and whatever you want to make, just format axis title. Axis title, if you want to make what you want to, border color you want to change, or fill, solid fill, if you want to change the select your solid fill, which color you want, just go through with that. Okay, like this we can format not only the legends, the value axis, even the data series also we can make a changes by using the formatting. Just you have to select the chart and right click, whatever you want, just place your cursor what you want to format. Okay, the next one, next one is what, changing the background. I told you formatting the legend, regarding that changing the scale values. Okay, formatting the data series, just which area you want to place your cursor, right click, whatever you want to change. I will learn about consolidating data. The consolidating refers to combining of data. You can combine the data of a various ranges either in the same or different worksheet. So for that sake we have to create two sheets, like the first quarter sales of 2013 and first quarter of sales of 2014. So what you have to do to consolidate the data in a different worksheet, it is essential to group the worksheets. Press and hold on the shift key and click on the sheet 3 tab. Okay, entering the main headings, already we have to enter the main headings, what we need, names of the common heading, subheadings, later ungroup them by right click and on any grouped sheet tab, select ungroup sheet tab. How we have to do that part I will show you now. Here already I created the sheet 1, that is what, a first quarter of a sale, okay, 2013, and here first quarter of a sale of a 2014. So what you have to do, holding the shift button, what you have to do, group the sheets. Okay, even sheet 2 I want also grouped, and I will open open sheet 3. I will place my cursor where I want. So click here on a consolidate. I am combining the data of sheet 1 and sheet 2. I want to see both the years data in the where 2013. How we have to do? Click here consolidate, and what you have to do? Open sheet 1. Okay, select the data. Select the data. Add it. Okay. Next, open sheet 2 data. Select it. Add it. Okay. Click on OK. See here, where I place my cursor, it will be displayed in that. And see here, both the year, how much after getting this one. See here, what, 1350, 2400, Okay, 2900. See here, sheet 1. You can see the data. How much we are having in the month of January? 450. Right? In sheet 3, you see 450 and sheet 2, 900. 450 plus 900, how much will get? 1350. So, it will combine the data of 2013 and 2014. Next, one is left. What? Finally, we learn about the grouping the sheet. By default, we are having the three sheets are displayed in the workbook with the name sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3. We can enter the data in all the three worksheets. The purpose of grouping the worksheet is to enter the common data, the formatting effect and formulas, and these steps of grouping the multiple worksheets. So how we have to do that one, I will show you in an Excel. Okay. So here, for example, just take a group, hold the shift button, hold sheet 2, I group and sheet 3. Okay. So here it is empty. Now you'll see sheet 3 also, you see here something, it is empty place. Now after some, if I made a changes here, 8888 if I made. Now you see the changes in a sheet 3 also, you can find 8888, right? Where we place your cursor, that will be the changes will be appear in a particular sheets. Here I finished your 7th lesson, advanced features of Excel. Thank you. Have a nice day.